What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Before we tackle today's problem, I want to briefly go over a simple math concept to make sure we are all on the same page, and that's median. The median is the middle value of a sorted integer list. Take this sorted list as an example. It contains 5 integers, meaning the median of this list is 8. In other words, if the size of the list is odd, we just take the middle value. However, if the size of the list is even, there is no middle value, and the median is the mean of the two middle values. So in the second example we see, the median is 9. Okay, with this out of the way, suppose we were asked to implement the MedianFinder class. This class consists of two methods, the findMedian method and the addNum method. When addNum is invoked, the integer num should be added to a data structure of our choice containing the previously passed numbers, and when the findMedian method is invoked, we should return the median of all the elements so far. Okay, the obvious solution that comes to mind is to store the numbers in a list, and sort that list every time we are asked to return with the median number. So, when the findMedian method is called, we sort the list, retrieve its size, and based on if its size is even or odd, we apply the formulas we just discussed. So, if it is even, we add the two middle values and divide their sum by 2. And if it is odd, we simply return the middle number. We can check if the size is even or not by making use of the modulo operator, or we can keep track of it using a boolean that is reversed every time we add a number. The solution works. However, it is not optimal at all, since it is governed by the sort operation. Its time complexity is n log n, so as we add numbers, the time it takes to return the median will drastically worsen. How can this be improved? Well, if we were to divide this list into two lists, storing approximately the same number of elements, what would we obtain? Let's visualize this with the help of an example. Take the list we see in front of us. If this list is divided into two separate lists, that's what the outcome would be. Notice how the last element of the first list and the first element of the second list are the values we need to obtain the median. But how does this help us? Well, to benefit from this approach, you will have to notice something else. You see, the lists are sorted, making the last element of the first list the maximum of that list, and the first element of the second list the minimum of that list. Now, which data structure allows us to retrieve the maximum and minimum in constant time? That's right, heaps, and they are represented as priority queues in Java. So, instead of having two lists, what about having two heaps? The first one will be a maximum heap, since what we want to return is the maximum value here, and the second one will be a minimum heap, since what we want to return is the minimum value of this list. Now, let's bring back the MedianFinder class and create the two priority queues we mentioned. One will return the minimum and the other the maximum in constant time. To find the median, all we have to do is peek at both the maximum and minimum of each priority queue and divide their sum by 2 if the total number of elements is even. And if it is odd, we return with the one stored inside the queue containing one additional element. In this implementation, it will be the maximum heap. And let's see why. The queue containing an extra element in case the total number of elements is odd will be determined by the addNum method. You see, to ensure a fair distribution of the numbers between the two heaps, we can alternate in adding one number to the max heap and another to the min heap. However, we can't randomly add these numbers, because if we add a number to the first queue that turns out to be bigger than all the numbers in the second queue, we'll be in trouble. To fix this, every time we add an element to a queue, we need to poll the respective minimum or maximum of that queue and add it to another one. To visualize this, suppose we have the filled queues of 6 numbers we see, and we are attempting to add number 12. Based on the code, we will add it to the minimum heap and transfer the minimum number, which in this case is 10, to the first queue or max heap. Without the transfer, we wouldn't have the correct median. If we attempt to add number 20 next, it will go to the max queue first and then be transferred to the min queue, since it is the current maximum of the list. Without the transfer, 20 would have remained in the first queue and messed up our answers. Now, because we chose to offer the number received to the maximum priority queue in case the size is even, this made that queue the one holding an additional element and the one that should be used to return the median in case the total number of elements is odd. If we swap the queues used in the addNum method, then the minimum priority queue will have to be used instead of the max one. Both of these implementations will return the correct median and have similar time and space complexities. The link to the LeetCode problem we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.